A reverse shoulder replacement is when we replace the shoulder, but we actually replace the socket with a ball and the ball with the socket. When there's a rotator cuff tear, the shoulder, instead of being here, it slides out of place. And when it slides out of place, that causes more bone loss and more pain as the humerus here bumps into the acromion here. In a standard shoulder replacement, you can see we replace the ball part of the joint with a ball and the socket with a socket. And the geometry of the shoulder is similar. The reverse shoulder replacement puts a ball type component where the socket was and a socket type component where the ball was. And now this is a more stable configuration that enables the deltoid muscle to perform the function that the rotator cuff, which is torn, once did. A candidate for reverse shoulder replacement is someone who either has arthritis and a tear of the rotator cuff tendons, or significant bone loss around the shoulder, or has had a failed shoulder replacement. The day of surgery, they come to the hospital and meet our anesthesiologist and our great team of people that we have here. The patient's asleep during the operation. When they wake up from surgery, they're in a sling, and we have the patient do some simple exercises after surgery just to keep the shoulder loose. The surgery benefits patients by improving their function and significantly reducing or completely eliminating their pain. A lot of orthopedic surgery is done here at Mary Immaculate Hospital, and the staff here, they're doing orthopedics every day of the week. I chose to become an orthopedic surgeon because in orthopedic surgery, patients tend to get better, and it's really gratifying.